Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Edison 32K Media. Today I have another product review for you guys, and I'm going to be reviewing an OBD2 port scanner. And I wanted to give a big thank you to Intey for sending me this product to review. I'm going to try to give you guys a very fair and unbiased opinion on this product. We're going to also go ahead and test it out on my TSX and my S2000 and just plug it in and see if we can scroll through the menus and read the codes. I think my TSX and my S2000, they don't have any engine light or anything like that at the moment, but we can kind of go through the option and see what's, I guess, offered to you as a consumer. So without further ado, this is the product. It's shipped in a box. I got it off of Amazon, and I'll put a link in the description below, and it looks just like this. So OBD2 is equipped on all 1996 vehicles and higher. So if you guys have a 1996 car, and up, you can actually look underneath your car and there's a connection, and you actually plug in the OBD port into that. And I guess it's good for when you have an engine light on, for example, and you don't have a scanner, you're not going to be able to know what's wrong with your car. So by plugging in an OBD port scanner, you can actually read the code. And in certain modules, the device will actually tell you what's wrong with the car and how to fix it. But I don't know if this one will do it or not, but we'll find out. So yeah, let's go ahead and take it out of the box.
So as you guys can see, I took it out of the box right here. This is a unit. It's fairly decent size. It's about, I guess, 3.5 inches by 2 inches. It's about the size of my hand for comparison. That you guys don't know, I have medium-sized hands. This is the OBD2 port. This actually plugs directly into your OBD2 port card in your car. And as you can see here, I'll give you guys like a close-up of the device. It's pretty nice. I guess the color is orange. I guess it's easy to keep track of in case you actually put it somewhere in your garage and you look for this thing, you know, it'll stand out. These are the enter button here, down, up. The exit button. And there's also a micro USB port right here, and I'm guessing this is for, like, you can either charge it or you can actually pull information from it, or you can actually update firmware, I'm thinking. So it's pretty handy. That way, you know, you can get all the latest updates and everything like that. So there's a warning label on the back. But yeah, let's go outside and we see if we can plug this into my car. We're going to use this in my S2000 and my TSX to see if we can get some information to pull up and see how everything goes. So yeah, let's get to it, guys. All right, guys, we have the Intey OBD2 port scanner right here. And we're gonna plug this basically into my Acura TSX and just kind of go to the menus and see if it provides, you know, clear instructions and clear guidelines and if the readout is fairly simple. So we're gonna put it to the test today. So on the Acura TSX, the 2005 models, the OBD2 port scanner is right on the driver's side seat. If you look directly below where you open the trunk latch, it's right there. So go ahead and plug in the OBD2 port scanner. Just plug it in. And as you guys can see, it automatically turns on and it powers up the LCD. It says turn the ignition to on. Press any key to con. Continue. So it's pretty cool. A lot of OBD2 port scanners, you plug it in and nothing comes on. But this one is cool because it actually tells you that you need to turn the key or else you can't read any codes. That's a really, really, it's a good thing. So we're gonna go ahead and put the key into the ignition and turn it on. So as you guys can see here, here's the main menu. We're just gonna go to the diagnostics and hit enter. And it's linking to my vehicle, waiting for it to respond. So, codes found 0. Monitors NA, monitors OK, monitors INC. So basically, I don't have any codes in my car. You can go to the menus. You either read your codes, go to erase codes. This is good for, like, if you fix something in your car and you want to erase the code and see if the problem will come back. This is good for that. Live data. Let's try this out. Let's see what this is. Reading PID.
So these are, I guess, are all the options in your car that the computer generates out. So you can read the map sensor, RPMs, you can read VSS, you can read IAT, a lot of things that you can read on here. A lot more things than my other OBD2 that I have. So which is really, really good. You can even read fuel systems. A lot of really good information in here. So let's exit out of here. Let's go to view freeze frame. No freeze frame data stored. Vehicle info, let's check this out. Turn key to on with engine off. We did already. Okay, reading info. Vehicle ID number. Check this out. Wow, it even tells you the VIN. So you can make sure that the VIN matches up with the VIN on front of the car. So if you're buying a car, this is a really good feature to have. Calibration ID, protocol. Let's go see what else is in here. So basically you have the menu basically consists of these options. So read codes, erase codes, live data, views, freeze frame, IM readiness, and vehicle info. So let's go back another level. Are you sure you want to exit? Go ahead and hit yes. So you can see the language. You can put in a bunch of languages. We'll leave it on English because it's my native language. Contrast, you can actually edit the contrast. So you can make it darker or brighter. Unit of measure. You can actually set it to metric or English. That's totally up to you. Pretty cool.
So although I think this OBD2 port scanner from Intey is very solid, it's really well made, it has a lot of really cool features that you know you would normally find another that you get for this price range. Check out the link in the description below to their product. I actually like it. The other one that I have basically just shoots out codes, and I can just read the code, but I can't really basically sort through the menus, control the contrast, get PID readings. I can't really read like the AFR, or like I can't read like engine temperatures or anything like that, but this little thing can all do it. So I really recommend this for you guys. It's really solid. Like once again, here's a close-up of the unit, and it's pretty small enough so that you can carry around your car and put it in the glove compartment and forget about it. And I think every person should have this in their car, like just in case you're driving somewhere and you get an engine light. Sometimes the problems can be serious, or sometimes the problems are not that serious. So it's good to know and have this thing in hand ready. So, I mean, if my car ever has any codes, you know, I'm definitely going to check this out. I'm definitely going to use this. And if you guys have any questions or comments, please like and subscribe and post down below. And I'll talk to you guys soon. Peace.